watch content, my friend. He's crazy as hell. Hey there, hi there, ho there, welcome to another edition of Road Trip. I'm Ron Rodden. Thanks for making Road Trip part of your Saturday and kicking off another good weekend. We're on every Friday night from 11:30 to midnight before Jennifer Day TV. And of course, Sci-Fi Ninja Peter at 12:30 here on Brooklyn Free Speech 1. We hope you can join us for a great Friday of 4 hours, 2 hours of good stuff here. For the last 2 weeks, we've taken a look at some of the best cars and some automobiles and some terrific stuff. But tonight, we're going to show you a few more things on this auto show, one of which I had a chance at two challenges. One, I was doing a car challenge to try to put the right car into the right zone, and you'll see why in just a little while. Also, I get a chance to challenge a TTR in a road test world. It's like a video thing, not the real deal, but a video road test world. So it's going to be very exciting. But I'll tell you, from all this, the adrenaline rush, to Camp Jeep, to take a look at some of the best expensive cars, like there's a Maserati over $130,000, there's electric cars, that's anywhere from $35,000 $130,000. There's a lot going on at the New York Auto Show. And of course, next year's auto show is going to be even more exciting than ever before. Now, speaking of cars, we have a special announcement too. Coming soon here on Road Trip, we're going to go from extraordinary cars to antique. I want to show you some of the best antique cars there is. The fantastic antique car show that was held at Floyd Bennett Field. And we're going to take a look at some of the best classic, unusual, classic Cali cars, from a Rolls Royce to a Camaro to a Mustang. That's really easy, isn't it? You'll see why coming up soon on an upcoming episode of Road Trip. Well, we got big stuff coming up this summer and all kinds of good things going on. And so stay with us. It's going to be a great way to start the summer off right here on the show. But right now, we begin tonight on this. You know, we've been talking about cars throughout this last 3 weeks. But one thing I want to get off my chest is about selling cars online. That, boy, getting you a scam. And why scamming is very, very difficult, you'll see why in this segment. For example, if you buy a car in an illegal car lot or anything that's online, avoid the, there's gonna be plenty of consequences about this, and I'll tell you why. For example, if you sell a car online, any sell a car is contacted by many people. A long story short, PayPal payments. If you have PayPal, regular car on your own, that's good enough. But on someone else's PayPal, you set up your account and then put in there, that's even worse. Let me tell you what all this means. This is the most secure pay. So making one payment through that takes a car. Then can anything else happen? Well, the answer is withdraw his money. That is a no-no right there. Another thing is, answers and talked by PayPal email, if you give us all personal information, that rips off also, because if you give information from you and everything else and it goes to some other person or some other email or some other address, that rips off everything. That is the one thing, because worst parts about selling a car online makes it terrible. Another thing is $1,500 in transactions about a PayPal user. Well, that's also cannot withdraw in 21 days. If you have $1,500 for sale, can accept a transaction of $1,500 plus, you really want to wait 21 days. That's 3 weeks of it. Might you had. That's because you can't get it earlier. There's a hold on it. That's what this is, hold the transaction. You're not to verify car sales, protect the seller on PayPal. If you arrange shipping via verify, you must have proof of shipping. And the way the car scan works, when you would pay you once they have the car, it could be the very big difference. Because why? Let me tell you this. PayPal's claiming account hacked and authorized transition. PayPal will contact you at the time of proof of delivery, and of course PayPal will get the verified address. The other coming scams is fake email from a PayPal saying the money is sent, but your account has been verified, has been picked up. No, not what PayPal works. Let me tell you why. The only way to avoid scams is as follows. Meet the seller in person, either have to pay cash or meet their bank in person, or join a cashier's check. Now that's cashier's check, is very good. It is not counterfeit. Make sure that's more important. You must have a notary free report from a bank unless the one witness the bill of state that the car is sold without any warranties whatsoever. Anybody else will scam you? Well, here's some more. You tell the buyer you're sorry you can't open a PayPal account where you pay a victim of fraud. Your account will be banned. And once the car you meet in is banned, the cash, and he gets a cashier's check, but you have to bank with him to verify the check is not, and I repeat, not counterfeit whatsoever. That's why he won't agree to buy you. Next, PayPal payments can be reversed in a bunch of reasons. If by using a stolen account reports the payment fraudulent, it is the one that the buyer claims the correct product is another. The transactor is too big to use PayPal. Go to the bank instead, and this is what it all says. Go to the bank to manipulate their transaction. Now most banks have the service of very low fees and peace of mind. Okay, those are good things about everything. Everybody in the emails have been sending a lot of good things about PayPal. So avoid, like this, avoid getting a card. This is my number one thing from all the illegal things. But also make sure the car must be licensed by a car dealership. They have a mostly licensed person that represents a dealership of your car. Two, always check for excellent. If the whole car is excellent, in good shape, fine, it will be happening. But remember, avoid the scams of these PayPals. Once you get everything wrong about all this, if I were you, don't buy a car. Just go to the real dealership and get it for real. That's one of the most important things. So those are advice I want to give you that happens a lot. All right, so we've seen cars happen, and you see most important things about new cars and everything else. But after the break, we're going to show you, very important, because this is going to be the parking challenge that I wanted to get into a car that will give you the correct parking, plus a challenge that you cannot believe, and this is so fun, you cannot believe you'd be driving like, well, face a tough closed road course. And by the way, it's not real, it's on video, virtual reality. You'll see all that why when we come back from this break.
Want a new way of learning math? Check out Easy Access Math on YouTube. It's math made easy.
Well, it's a... Welcome back, everybody. Well, it's a car. It's a motorcycle. No, it's a Marengue. No, I'm just kidding about that. No, we're talking about this unusual car with a combined with a motorcycle to a car. Why? Well, from Atabato, Eric Fritz joins us right now. Eric, how are you doing, sir?
I'm good. How are you?
So, everybody, I'm a little confused first in the first place. Sure. I haven't seen this firsthand. But two seats, one looks like a motorcycle, looks like a car, looks like a big... But what is this vehicle look like?
This is the Arcimoto Fun Utility Vehicle, or FUV. It actually technically is a motorcycle. It's federally classified as a motorcycle.
Yeah.
License and helmet laws vary from state to state.
Hmm.
But it is built to be the most efficient vehicle for everyday driving.
Wow.
You know, typical drivers are one passenger carrying around 4,000 pounds of steel driving less than 40 miles a day.
Yeah, and here's the reason this gentleman right behind there, what's his name?
Jeff.
Jeff, you were just inside this vehicle, so how do you like it in here?
That's actually comfortable.
That's great. So this is like a two vehicles, like one set in front and one in back. And this is go like in also on highway and some little thing?
Street legal in all 50 states, highway legal and go 80 miles an hour. Mm-hmm. It is fully electric, 70 miles on a charge from the base model, 130 miles with an upgraded battery pack.
Amazing! And this is great. And they got the gas or just charging by
It's all electric. All electric.
All electric. And it's absolutely one of the best kind of sport utility vehicles there is. And if I'm looking at this right now, I'm going to show you how it looks real inside. I don't think the camera will ever do that with this. This is what it looks like here. And the base price of this kind of unfortunately show the grip away is like
$11,900.
That's a very good deal, isn't it?
Yeah, I agree.
So you need a driver's license? Boy, you need one anyway. It's just like a real motorcycle. It's fantastic. What's the website for this one?
www.arcimoto.com. That's A-R-C-I-M-O-T-O.
That's a great website. Fantastic. I don't know. You know, I'm going to go back to my driver's license. That's the one I go on. This is one of these things.
Exactly.
Absolutely. It's automoto.com. It's a website. Check it out. It's fantastic.
Thank you.
Well, taking challenges is every car thinking about it. And today, no strangers attacked because I'm in this challenge. The Volkswagen Golf is one of the most popular cars in the GTI. But today, I'm going to take the challenge on driving in a test challenge. It's like a simulator, and it's very exciting. Take a look. All right, folks, you see challenges, you see cars, and big cars means racing. We have a Golf GTI challenge, and this is going to be a lot of fun because we have this man right here. And you are?
Bob,
and you're from Connecticut?
Yep.
And so you know you're being similar cars and parts of the neighbor's line?
I don't think I've ever driven one of these.
Never one of these?
Well, it'll be a new experience.
Well, it's the same here for me because, you know, I've done parts and layers before and everything, but not in a real car like this.
Yep.
So we're going to challenge the best who's drive better. I'm representing white. This man's going to set up the red.
Be the red.
Who is what's better? Let's find out. Okay, ready to do this?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Here we go.
Thank you. tell you, folks, it's worth the payoff.
Well, man, you did a great job.
You're a good racer.
Thank you very much. It's not for what you do with the car, but it was something like that. So that was a good job, Robert. Nice job. Well done.
Yeah. Listen, stick around. We have a lot more coming up, a road trip. See you after the break.
Hey, this is Art Kurtz at the Mill Basin Day Camp Game Show Studio, inviting you to come down and join us on our game shows, and dozens of other great activities, too. How can I join?
If you want to get in the game and join the fun, come on down to Mill Basin Day Camp. We've got great activities all summer long, like the Game Show Studio, Mill Basin's Got Talent, the Computer Room, Arts and Crafts, dance, and a whole lot more. So come on down to Mill Basin Day Camp and have some summer fun. For more information, call 718-251-6200. That's 718-251-6200.
Hey guys, this is my teenage friend Fred.
Rad! Hey, pal, you want to pay attention to the road?
Relax, man, I got it.
Look, my man, if your bad driving gets me killed, you better hope you die too, or I will haunt you silly. And I'm not just going to float over your bed like, woo! I'm going to be making a more annoying noise, like, ah! And instead of wearing those long white robes, I think I'll wear something more form-fitting and upsetting. The other ghost will look and be like, wow, we've never seen that before.
Welcome back, everybody, to Road Trip. In celebration of the 50th anniversary of Clark Wheels, we present this car as one of our dream cars. This is the Chevrolet Camaro sports car, the convertible. It's a terrific Hot Wheels replica of the 1968 real thing in the color orange. Every standard feature included, four seats, a GPS system, and a lot more. The value of the car with this replica is valued at least $35,000. And on our Hot Wheels, this is one great Camaro. And you can check it out at ChevyOffers.com.
All right, so we met one of our pets from the terrific old Ruff House. And we have another Ruff House dog who is very informed. I'm going to meet her in a second. But this beautiful young lady's name is Joy.
Yes, I am.
Joy Alcaro.
Alcaro.
Volvo. And we have some great dogs here we have just seen right now. And this is a little cutie, so I want to show her. Get the camera down.
Louisa.
Hey, Louisa. Hey, how are you?
This is Louisa.
It's so cute. There's also another pet rescue right here.
Yeah. And that's Ruff House.
Yes. So tell us about, so we talked a lot about Ruff House. Now, you also partner with Volvo in a very important charity. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so back in February at the Chicago Auto Show, we decided to make an announcement that Volvo Cars USA and the Pet Finder Foundation would start up a partnership. And what we're doing is we're trying to bring awareness to pet safety in our cars, and also that Volvo is one of the only manufacturers who has accessories for pets to keep your pet safe and keep yourself safe when you're traveling.
Yes, indeed, indeed.
So we do have all kinds of harnesses that we have for our dogs. They come in four different sizes, depending on what size dog you have. And we also have cargo and pet gates for the back area.
Now, we got a lot of pet gates, and I saw one behind me.
Yes.
One of these cars here.
Yes, we do.
And we just showed you that just moments ago. It is
but let
great.
Me just, what I wanted to say was that there are many states that it's a legal requirement to have your pet restrained in your car. So you shouldn't be driving with your pet on your lap or just roaming loose. God forbid you're in an accident, there's a collision. It's an object in your car. It can hurt you, it can hurt the animal. So there are certain states, including the state of New Jersey, and most of all of the Northeast, like Vermont, Hampshire, Massachusetts, Maine, who have legal requirements that you must have your pet restrained. So a harness or in the back of a cargo area is the best place to be traveling.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I call safety, because we see a lot of animals killed who's not in the safety harness or anything like that. And there's about more than hundreds of animals a year that will kill in terms of driving.
Sure, sure.
That is a beautiful thing about this, and this And we're glad that Volvo and great foundation.
Here's another thing what we're doing is we're helping the Pickfinder Foundation because they work with local charities, right? They're a nonprofit organization whose mission is to save all adoptable pets from euthanasia. So any pet accessory that's purchased from Volvo, we donate $10 to the Pickfinder Foundation for each pet accessory.
Absolutely fantastic. And we love you. Thank you for making it here. So what is the website you want to check more about this?
So if you go to volvocars.com/US, we do have a pet landing page.
She was on my camera so I came in. She was a TV clown around here, isn't she? Okay, so VolvoCars.com is the website.
Yes, and there we have a pet landing page and it tells you all about our pet accessories and also a link to the Pickfinder Foundation.
That is a beautiful charity and we love our pets here. I'm talking about cars very quickly. And so very quickly, we were talking at the top of the segment about Tomb Raider. It's one of the cars that features in this one.
The XC40. The XC40 is featured in the Tomb Raider movie.
That's great. And what kind of beautiful cars we got this year for Volvo?
Well, our brand new car is the XC40. So that one is, it's up there. Where's its Tomb Raider?
Yeah.
And we have, they're just being released this month. So now's the time to go out and place your orders and order them. And they come in all different colors and mix and match.
And it's just in time for 2019. Check out this great website. Check out not only this Pet Parent Foundation on the Volvo site, also check out wildclubs.org, our own website. And we love our pets, and we thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And we love our pets, and we love to hear from you. And if you want to donate, we'll link it up on our website, and you'll see on our Facebook page, on YouTube, all of our pages right here on Road Trip. When we come back, a question that says everything about this car and everything you want to know. This is the clue I gave you when we started the show 2 weeks ago. We asked you, this car was the same used in the movie 50 years ago. Do you know the answer? Stay tuned and we'll be right back.
Average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds.
Okay, folks, welcome back. Now, before the break, we asked you this question, and this is a very serious one. Here it is. The car that you're seeing behind me, it's the same movie that was filmed 50 years ago. Okay, I'll give you a little clue. The movie that stars Steve McQueen is in this one. You don't know? Well, here it is. Take a look at the answer. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2018 Ford Mustang Bullet. This is from the 1968 movie Bullet that starred Steve McQueen that brought him an Oscar. It was one of the best box office movies in the time of 1968. But 50 years later, this car you see here is upgrading like never before. And if you want to look about this new car, well, take a look at this. It's the rebuilt 2018 Ford Mustang Bullet. It started at under $27,000. This fantastic remodel has a lot of good things with 6-position front brakes, anti-roll bar, a bigger 5-liter V8 engine, and extended chassis. This brand new Ford Bullet is absolutely fantastic, and you can check it out
at Ford.com.
And this bullet and I is going to be heading out to the road right now for the next run. I want to thank everybody. The New York Golf Show on the end of the year. I think I'm one of the greatest cars in the year to drag stuff and everything else. And I just want to thank you very much for making Golf Club a great show. Next week, it's another crusade. It's the Battle of the Boys, battling out for Dragon Ball. Next up, our special Memorial Day weekend edition of Golf Club. So, I want to say ahead of time, to thank the men and women for serving our nation. We'll see you again next week from Cafe Giano in Brooklyn for Who Said It at $167.31. Right now, it's time to get ready to follow by Live by YouTube. Everybody, the part of the show. And we all show. I'm Ron Ron. Thanks for joining us. Good night. Bye bye. And bye bye.
Is a Ron Rondon video production.
This is Don Wilson saying good night.